Where? Over there? Can I adjust it over there? I'm going to have to. No, we don't need that. No. Okay. All right. Ready when you are. Give me the thumbs up. I need you on me. I need you on me. Good evening, everyone. I bid a warm welcome to you all at the start of our novena. Our Pentecost novena. I'm really looking forward over the next 90 evenings as we pray together and prepare for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Just for this. Okay, just getting a technical glitch out of the way, but I'm happy so many of us were able to join us this evening at the start of our Holy Spirit Novena. You know, the Holy Spirit Novena is the oldest novena in the world because it started with the apostles waiting in that upper room for the coming of the Holy Spirit upon them. And once that Holy Spirit came upon them, it made all the difference in their lives. They were a bunch of scared persons hiding away from the Roman authorities, afraid to go out. And then the Holy Spirit came and emboldened them to go out and to spread the good news. And that is my prayer for us as well, that over these 9 evenings, the Holy Spirit will prepare our hearts, will rekindle the fire of God's love within us, will give us the boldness to share our faith, and will bless us with all the fruits and the gifts as well. And I challenge us to steer the course and to stay with us over the next 9 evenings. So as we always do, we want to start with the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our topic for today is charity. I prefer to use the word charity than love. And we will be praying for greater charity in our hearts. So let's begin by inviting the Holy Spirit to come upon us. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of your faithful, grant that by that same Spirit we may always be truly wise and ever rejoice in his consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for the gifts of the Spirit. We need these gifts to practice our faith on a daily basis in today's world. And think of these gifts as practical things that you can practice in your life as well. So let us pray together. Loving God, renew in our hearts the sevenfold gifts of your Spirit, wisdom, knowledge, and reverence, right judgment, and courage, wonder, and awe, that our lives might bear an abundant harvest of the fruits of your Spirit, love, joy, faithfulness, and trust, patience, gentleness, kindness, modesty, chastity, and self-control, goodness, and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, so I invite us to relax and to sit down as we reflect on our topic for today, the gift of charity. So let us reflect on that for a moment. As I mentioned, I prefer to use the word charity rather than love, because love has all kinds of emotional connotations, whereas charity probably gets a little bit closer to what true love is all about. So let's say this prayer together as we reflect and pray for charity in our hearts. Holy Spirit, Lord of light, from your clear celestial height, your pure beaming radiance give. And let us say this prayer together. Almighty and eternal God, who has chosen to regenerate us by water and the Holy Spirit, and has given us forgiveness of all our sins, you're not changing his lines. Almighty and eternal God, who has chosen to regenerate us by water and the Holy Spirit, and has given us forgiveness of all our sins, you chose to send forth from heaven upon us your sevenfold Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and fortitude, the Spirit of knowledge and piety, and fill us with the Spirit of holy fear. Amen. So let's reflect a bit on the gift of charity, because I really want to pray today that God's charity may be present in the hearts of all of us. We need charity in the world that we live in today. One of the biggest letters on charity is found in St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13. It is often quoted in weddings and used by brides and grooms in weddings. And you know, it helps us all to understand what God really demands of us when we think of practicing charity in our lives. It's not an emotional thing at all. It is the real presence of the Holy Spirit in our hearts, changing us, allowing us to reach out in a spirit of true love to others. And we often think of charity as donating cash to other people, giving something to someone who is poor. But when you read St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13, it's not really about that at all. It is about giving of yourself to the other. We live in times today that really require us to give more of ourselves to people, because people are in pain. Our communities are in crisis. Families are struggling today and experiencing great hardship. And more than ever, I think it is required of us to be charitable people. Are you charitable in your home? Because I hear people saying, for instance, they are very irritable. And sometimes when we are irritable, we tend to take out our frustration on people instead of pausing a few moments and allowing the Holy Spirit to strengthen us in those moments. This is a time when people need more laughter and compassion practiced in a practical way on a daily basis in our homes. Instead of giving in to the frustrations of COVID and being, you know, not being able to go out and do things, we have to set the example in our homes and in our communities. And as I said, charity to me in COVID times means two things: laughter and compassion. It also means reaching out. How many of us have used the opportunity to get in touch with grandparents, elderly persons, brothers and sisters, just to find out how they are doing, rather than feeling sorry for ourselves at home and thinking about all the things that we cannot do? This is a time that calls for us to be kind to others as well. So let's pray today as we begin our novena for a spirit of true charity in our hearts and in our homes as well. We will all say one Our Father, the Hail Mary, and the Glory Be. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. So we pray for that spirit of charity in our hearts today. It is something that is absolutely necessary and so much in demand in our homes. We'll now have a blessing and a closing prayer for everyone. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, this evening as we gather on the very first evening of our novena. We pray and ask you, Lord, to extend your hand of blessing upon us all. I invite us now to just open our hands with our palms facing upwards. Lord, we pray for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon us all, that Holy Spirit may come upon us and touch us, touch our minds, that we will be free from fear and frustration. Touch our bodies, Lord, that we may be safe from all ailments. Touch our spirits, that we may not be tempted by the evil one. Touch our emotions, Lord, that we will continue to open our hearts in a spirit of charity towards our brothers and sisters, that there will be laughter in our homes, that there will be care for each other, that we, Lord, will reach out in a spirit of kindness to those who are in need. Lord, on the very first evening of our novena, fill us with your presence. Give us all the gifts of the Holy Spirit and guide us on the way to eternal life. We offer a special prayer today for those who have not been well. And Lord, we include not only those who are not physically well, but those who are feeling low and frustrated and empty and lonely and cut off. We pray for those who have become depressed. And we ask you, Lord, as we pray for them, that you will give them strength and courage. We pray for the elderly, those who live alone and have no one to care for them. And we pray for our young ones as well, that you will protect them, Lord, at all times and keep them safe in your care. Lord, many marriages have suffered during this COVID time. And we ask you to bless these marriages, Lord, and heal them and strengthen them and make them even stronger, that husband and wife will learn to care for each other and minister to one another. And bless the relationship between children and parents as well, Lord, that there will be due respect and prayer in our homes. Bless us all as we start our novena today. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. So I want to thank you all for coming out this evening and for being here with us. We continue, and I challenge us, as I said, over the next 9 evenings to come out for the prayers and the blessings as we pray that the Holy Spirit will prepare our hearts for the coming of Pentecost. Good evening, everyone. We end with some music.
As we go, go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference, we can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference in the world.
Yeah, give us another one.
You